यस सो द थर्ड क्वेश्चन वी फाइंड प्रोटोप्लाज्म में लिविंग कंटेंट एंड साइटोप्लाज्म एंड प्रोटो न्यूक्लियस टुगेदर कॉल्ड प्रोटोप्लाज्म. So, cell theory was proposed by Schleiden
and Schwann. Then you write that living contents of a cell is called protoplasm.
Living content is protoplasm, but you have to explain also. Means like cytoplasm plus nucleus together it is called protoplasm. Cytoplasm and nucleus together it is called protoplasm. So first question was the cell theory proposed by Schleiden and Schwann, and it is revived by Rutherford. And then the second question, how was the term cell derived? So how was the cell derived? The cell was you told that it is derived by from the word Latin word cellula, but how was? Means what?
When Robert Hooke used his microscope, and then he discovered that these tiny structures are called cells, and types of cells like red cells, white
blood cells, many cells.
Hamza Khamar, you all, I will give you chance to you also one by one. Now Hamza Khamar, you tell what you want. Yes, both are. Now tell me. What you were saying?
Ma'am Robert Hooke saw with his microscope a cork of a cell, cork of a dead plant cell. Ma'am, he see a small rooms or a chamber, ma'am, which he called a cellula after.
Yes.
After some time, it is called cell.
So Robert
Hooke. Ma'am, can tell next one question.
When I ask you, then only you will speak, okay? So many students are there, they should also get chance, okay? Okay, now Sabra, unmute yourself and tell me the next answer of the question. That what is the function of cell membrane? Sabra, what is the function of cell membrane? Sabra, unmute yourself. Sabra, am I audible to you? Zakwan, you tell me. Zakwan, am I not audible? So many students, they just not. They are just. I mean, no response is there. Even I'm calling the name. At least at that time, you can give response. Yes, ma'am. If you don't know the answer, you can tell. I don't know. It's okay. But at least give response. How would I know you are there in the class? Amin Huda, you unmute yourself and give me the answer of the next question. What is the function
yes,
of...
Yes, ma'am.
What's the function of cell membrane?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the function of cell membrane?
Yes, ma'am. What is the question?
What is the function of cell membrane?
The function of cell membrane is to not enter other substances in the cell and protect the cell.
Cell membrane function, of course, protect the cell, give the shape to the cell. And allow means it's a selective membrane, so it selects the substances for the cell. Select the substances which is supposed to enter or exit from it. Okay, now the next question. Hana Ubaid. Hana? Hana?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me the answer of the next question. What are genes? Where are genes located and what is their function?
Okay, ma'am, 1 minute, just.
The last question I asked, okay. Where are the genes located? What is their function?
And what? Yes, ma'am.
Tell me.
Ma'am, the chromatin contains hereditary units called genes that are passed on from the parent to the offspring.
So where are genes located? Genes are located on the chromatin material and its function is to carry the character from parent to the offspring. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, let's move to the next exercise, that is long answer question. And the first is, what does the cell theory state? So what does the cell theory state? Now, this Farhan Ayatullah. Farhan Ayatullah, unmute yourself. Farhan? Farhan Ayatullah, unmute yourself. Hassan Ahmed. Hassan Ahmed. Ubaida, Ubaida, unmute yourself and give me the answer of the question.
Which question?
Ubaida.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, what is the cell theory state? What long what? Answer? What does the cell theory state means? The points which are included in the cell theory. Just tell. You have to tell those points.
Beings are made up of cells.
Yes.
Cell is the basic structure of life.
Yes.
A structure of functions and unit of life.
Okay. So, say all the living being made up of cell, and cell is a structural and functional unit of life. And later on, Varko added one more point, that is, cells arise from the pre-existing cell. Now the next question, are a multicellular organism advanced as compared to the unicellular organism? Give three reasons in support of your answer. Means you just tell how the multicellular organisms are advanced. Means what you can say, more evolved. Yes, Fayaz. Fayaz, you unmute yourself. Hafsa. Hafsa Fatma, you unmute yourself and tell me quickly.
Yes, ma'am.
Question I ask. Multicellular organism advanced as compared to the unicellular organism. Give three reasons for that. How will you prove that multicellular organisms are advanced? Quickly. ओके हमजा हाउ आर यू टेल मी हमजा हमार कुसुम यू टेल मी कुसुम हाउ द मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म एडवांस यू जस्ट गिव थ्री रीजन
Unicellular organism because now in multicellular because in unicellular organism a single cell perform all the life functions and in multicellular organism different life functions are brought about by various group of cells and in unicellular they have a simple body organization and in multicellular they have a complex body organization and now in unicellular life span is short and in multicellular they have a longer life span
Yes.
That's why they are advanced.
Yes. So their division of labor is there in multicellular organism. Cell organelles are there in the multicellular organisms. Means like no cell organelles are there in unicellular also if they are eukaryotic. That's another thing. So how they are means to consider as more evolved, more advanced. Because their division of labor is there, they have the complex body organization and they have longer lifespan. So these are the points you can give in reference of this question. Now the third question, explain the structure of the nucleus with the help of a label diagram. Raise your hand. Explain the structure of the nucleus with the help of a Liebig diagram. Ayan Zubair. Ayan, you unmute yourself. And give me the answer. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Give me the answer, okay. Third that answer. Explain the structure of the nucleus.
Ma'am, nucleus is surrounded by, double layered membrane. Ma'am, and the nuclear membrane is surrounded by jelly-like fluid, the nucleoplasm. The nucleoplasm contains one or more spherical body called nucleoli. It also connects a network of thread-like structure called chromatin.
Very good. So, yes, anyone else? Muhammad Yusuf Azmi? Yusuf Muhammad Azmi?
Yes, ma'am.
Give me the answer of this question. Explain the structure of the nucleus. Yes?
Ma'am, I know the answer before it. Can I tell?
Okay.
Nucleus is usually spherical in shape. It controls all the activity of the cell and hence is called the brain of the cell.
Yes.
It is surrounded that the boy told.
Here you have to explain its structure. Means membrane, nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus, chromatin, chromatin fibers. These all you have to include in the reference of the answer. Otherwise also it is long answer. So you have to tell all the parts of the nucleus. Nuclear pore to enter or to exit the substances. A nuclear membrane is to protect or cover the genetic material. It's like this. Now the next question. What are plastids? Write an account on the different type of plastids found in plants. Isma, now you can tell.
Yes, ma'am.
You can tell.
And these plastids are found in plant cells. They are bound by a double membrane and can be oval, spherical, or discoid in shape. Based on their color, they are classified into following three types. And we are having three types of plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast.
Yes. So here, what are, I mean, like chloroplast, what are leucoplast, and what are the third one in the chloroplast, leucoplast, chromoplast. So you have to tell about all, means what are chromoplast like? Tell me.
I have to define three of them.
Okay.
Chloroplast. They are green plastids as they contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. They trap solar energy and convert into chemical energy in the form of food through the process of photosynthesis. And chromoplast, these are colored plastids. They contain red, orange, and yellow pigments. These colors attract insects and other animals for pollination. They are mostly found in the petals of flowers and fruits. Leucoplast, these are colorless plastids. They store food in the form of starch, proteins, and fats. They are found in the non-photosynthetic parts like roots and seeds of the plant.
Yes. Now the next question. So, here in this question, you have to write definition of
leucoplast. Ma'am, leucoplasts are non-photosynthetic because they are colorless.
Leucoplast function is to store the extra food in the leucoplast. It's extra food of the cell. Now, next question, draw a label like organ of typical animal cell. Animal cells, you have to draw neat and clean in your copy.
I'm in page number 42. We have to draw and we have to label all the parts.
Yes. Now differentiate between a plant cell and an animal cell. Means what are the differences are there between animal cell? Now let me give chance to there also. Let's see. Naba, you tell me. Naba, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Where are you? Just yes, Naba. Here you just have to differentiate. You have to tell the differences between the plant cell and the animal cell. What are the differences between these two?
What, ma'am? I cannot hear you.
Yes. What? I asked differentiate. Differentiate a plant cell and an animal cell. What are the differences between them? Yes.
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Okay. Khidr, you tell me. Khidr. Khidr. Khidr, you unmute yourself and give me the answer. Khidr.
Yes, ma'am.
Differentiate between a plant cell and an animal cell. Yes, quickly tell me. Few differences are there. Like in animal cell wall is not there. and in plant cell, cell wall is there. So in this way, you have to tell the differences between these two. Yes? No. Usama Kareem. Usama? Usama, am I audible to you? Yes, give me the answer of the sixth question. Long six. Difference between a plant cell and an animal cell. Plant cell and an animal cell. No? No one is telling there is. Isma, yes, you tell me. Isma?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, on page number 45, we are having the difference, means we are having seven differences, so we will write. Plant cells have a fixed geometrical shape. Animal cells, shapes of animals, animal cells vary. Second, plant cell, cell wall is present, and in animal cell, cell wall is not present. Plant cell plastids are present in the cytoplasm, and in animal cell, plastids are absent.
Hmm.
Plant cells, lysosomes are not present, and in animal cells, lysosomes are present in plant in the cytoplasm. Yes, ma'am.
Lysosomes are absent in plant cell, yes.
Yes, and in plant cells, large permanent vacuoles are present. They fill about 90% of the space inside the cell. Animal cell vacuoles, if present, are small. Plant cells, centrosomes are absent. Animal cells, centrosomes are present. Plant cells, nucleus is marginal in position. Animal cells, nucleus is central in position.
Yes, very good, mashallah. Very good. So many differences, Isma told. She told like lysosome, they are present in only animal cell, and centrosome is also present only in animal cell, and on the other hand, cell wall and plastids, they are present only in plant cell, and nucleus is marginal in plant cell because of the large vacuole, and the nucleus is centrally in the animal cell because in animal cell small vacuoles are there, sometimes absent also. So these points you can add in your answer of the sixth question. Now study, picture study. That is on the page number 49. Observe the figure and answer the question that follow. Here picture is beside the question, picture is there, A and B. So you just have to identify pictures. Raise your hand and identify. Tell me, Aman Jamal. Aman Jamal, are you here in the class? Aman, unmute yourself. Aman Jamal, not giving response also. Hafsa. Hafsa also not giving response. Hafsa.
Yes, ma'am.
Where is Hafsa?
Ma'am?
Yes, where is Hafsa? Hafsa, I'm not audible. You're not giving response at all. Okay. After you tell me the this, observe the figure and answer the question that follow. The first one means A and B picture. Just identify them. What are these pictures? Hafsa, what are these pictures on the page number 49? A and B pictures are there. Very easy it is. Hana, you tell me. Hana.
Can I tell?
Okay.
A1 is red blood cell and B is white blood cell.
Very good. Yes, A is red blood cell, B is white blood cell. Now the next, which of the following two figures represent an organism? Which of the two figures represent an organism? Which of the two figures represent an organism? Here, figures are not there. It's an incomplete question. Which of the two figures represent an organism?
Yes, ma'am. Like,
here could be, you know, animal cell or plant cell, something like that should be. But if on the basis of these two figures, like red blood cell and white blood cell, so it's there in the animal cell only. So if on the basis of the same figure that they asked the first A question, the question A, the part A is from the same figure. If the, because another picture is not there, if the same picture they are asking, then the organism would be animal only, because red blood cell, white blood cell, they are there in animal. Fine. Now the next question, what is the shape of A and B? Yes.
The red blood cell are biconcave and this
WBC.
Like for providing a greater surface area for absorbing oxygen, and white blood cell are irregular in shape so that they can squeeze out through the blood capillaries, fight infection causing germs.
Yes, here it is biconcave and WBC is irregular shape. Definite shape is not there, irregular shape is there. Now the next question, what special figure in A enables it to perform its function? What is the special feature? Sorry, not figure. What is special feature of A? Means red blood cell is there to perform its function. Means what is the function of RBC? Just raise your hand. What is the function of RBC? Yes, Yusuf Muhammad Azmi. What is the function of RBC? Quickly.
Red blood cells helps in providing a greater surface area for absorbing oxygen.
Attach oxygen, not absorb. Means hemoglobin is there on RBC, and with hemoglobin oxygen and carbon dioxide attach, means it's having capability to join or attach with oxygen and carbon dioxide so that it can carry oxygen and carbon dioxide within the body. Fine. Now the next question, identify the cell shown in the figure below and label its part. Yes, here, tell me which figure it is. Raise your hand.
Animal cell.
Yes, animal cell, yes. And here you have to label all the part. One part of the cell is? Aminuda, you tell me. Here, this figure is the labeled. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Till 8, it is labeled. So, tell me the one with the cell organelle which is labeled as 1. What is it? Aminuda. Yes, Aminuda.
Yes, ma'am.
What question I asked? Where are you? Yes, where are you, beta? Just now I asked. So, labeling is there on the figure? You just have to write the name in front of
her. My voice is breaking. Ma'am. Figure A is a red blood cell.
No. Second question I am on.
My voice is breaking.
I am on second question. The figure of the animal cell is there, na? That here,
yes,
this figure is labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So,
yes.
The one which is labeled, what is it?
One. Am I gonna tell?
Yes, okay. Quickly.
Mitochondria.
Yes, mitochondria. Hamza Khamar, second tell me. Second.
And the first one is mitochondria.
Mitochondria. And second?
And second, ma'am, it's centrosome.
Yes, very good. And third, raise your hand. Mohammad Darim. Tell me the third one. Darim is not there in class. Who is this? Assalamu alaikum. I am. Who is this? Write your name only so that I will.
I think Usaid. I can tell third one.
Yes, tell me.
Third one, it is nucleus.
Yeah, and third is not nucleus. Where are you?
Ma'am, then I don't know, ma'am. Third one is not nucleus.
Third one is not nuclear. Third one is lysosome.
Okay.
Now the fourth one, tell me.
Fourth one, it's Golgi bodies. Fourth one, Golgi bodies.
Yes, very good. Now the fifth one.
Nucleus.
Fine. And the fifth one. Sorry, nucleus. Sixth one.
This is nucleoplasm,
you can say, or directly you can say nucleus. Okay, nucleus then is seventh one is only. Sixth one is nucleoplasm. Yes, okay, correct. So sixth is nucleoplasm, seventh is nucleus, because one more arrow is there towards the nucleus, so there you write nucleus. Sixth is nucleolus, fifth is nucleoplasm, seventh is nucleus. Fifth is nucleoplasm, second is sixth is nucleolus, seventh is nucleus. And then eighth is raise your hand. Quickly. Yes, eighth is.
Rough endoplasmic reticulum.
RER. Good, Masala, very good. Now the next question. State whether it is a plant cell or an animal cell. Give two reasons in support of your answer. So this cell, this picture of the cell which is given in your book, tell me that is it.
Ma'am, this is animal cell.
And reason also you have to give then. What is the reason why it is animal cell?
Ma'am, I can tell.
Wait. Here, so many things. Centrosome is present. Then here, cell wall is absent. And then chloroplast is absent. Here, lysosome is present. So, centrosome, lysosome, they are present in the animal cell only. Cell wall, chloroplast, they are absent in the cell wall, in animal cell, and they are present in the plant cell. So because of this point, we know that this cell is of animal cell. Now the next is, lip is a part numbered 1 to 8 in the shape, in the figure. So just now we have discussed, now what are the function of 1, 2, 4, 7? 1 is mitochondria, 2 is centrosome.
I can tell.
Yes. Quickly.
Ma'am, first is mitochondria. Ma'am, second is.
No, what is the function of mitochondria? Function is to provide energy, that's why it is called powerhouse of the cell. Then second is centrosome. Centrosome is found near the nucleus and it's helpful in cell division. Its function is to initiate cell division. To initiate means start. And then the fourth one is the Golgi body. Its function is to packaging the material to form the lysosomes also. And then seventh is nucleus and it is the control center of the cell. Now, because time is over, it's 19 and we'll continue with this little few exercises are left in it, means the question 3, and then we'll start the chapter in the next class. So whatever I discussed here, that you complete in your notebook, and only the means like fill in the blank.
Ma'am, please tell me fifth one.
What fifth one? Fifth
in plant and animal cell.
Here in animal nucleoplasm. Fine?
Yeah.
So just all these exercises you complete. The exercises which you can complete in the book, like fill in the blank, matching, tick the correct option, these you can do in book. Rest all the exercises you have to do in the notebook. Fine? So complete all whatever I discussed today. Now, assalamu alaikum.